Hi guys, so I will show you how to correctly use Cable 2.0. Okay, so first let's see how to install this guy. You can install it with Maya Open, it's not a problem. So extract the zip file. You have a cable folder and the script. Okay, very simple. Just go to your document Maya and version in pref script, okay, be careful about pref script, and just copy cable script here. Okay, nothing to do more. Then go to Maya, open the script editor. Okay, create here with a plus button a new tab. Be careful to be well select Python. Then you have two solutions. The first one is you just drag and drop the point Python here. Okay, it's done. Or if that don't work for you, you have a point text file which is the same that is the first one. But you can open Ctrl A, copy, and Ctrl N paste. Okay. Once it's done, here you have the script. Just Ctrl A, middle mouse button, drag and drop into your shelf. And it's all. Okay. Now we will quickly edit this icon. Right click, edit. Okay. Shelf here. Let's rename that cable. Okay. And just change the icon. The icon is into the cable script folder. You have icon, you can choose which one you want. I will just copy this. Okay. So open, I copy paste. Okay. And just select the icon, save all, and it's okay. You have cable here. Just click and it's open. Well, so now let's talk about the basics for those who don't know the first version of Cable. First things, you can now dock the pop-up on the front side of my application. I will dock it on the right. Nice. So what is Cable? Cable allow you to easily and quickly create cable. Simple than that. For example, just into click, boom, you have a cable. Okay. So, how to create cable? First thing, you need a curve. For that, you have the four shortcuts here, the classic CV1, a Bezier 1. Let's add a bit more depth on this guy, for example. Nice. The pen 1. And a last, which allow you to create based on profile, for example, here. Okay, edge, I just click and it will create a curve based on edge selection. Okay. Nice. Then you just select your cable and it create cable. Okay. After that, you can edit one by one. You just select, for example, this guy, and you can modify some parameter like the scale, the width, which is a multiplier of the scale, the density to control the density, of course, section, really basics. Smoothing is great. For example, if you have some bad area like that, just add a bit of smoothing and that will in fact relax your cable. Twist, it's a little fix. In some case, you see where the edge loop are not really parallel. You can add that or not. You can make a twist if you want. And really, a little problem with that is, be careful, is not really a geometry. Okay, if I right click here, you see, in fact, it's not a mesh, it's a stroke. Okay, so I want to select my curve, but it's a bit complicated. You see, if I move the stroke, but not the curve. And to select the curve, I can't. Okay, so it's why there is a manipulation button. Just hit that, and now you directly select the curve. Okay, so it's easier. I come here, just right click, and now I have access to my curve to edit and works. Yeah, you can maybe. No, the X-ray don't want. Okay. So it's all for that. Once it's done, once you're happy with that, you need to bake. Because, for example, you can't modify, you can't apply a material, you can do nothing because it's not a geometry. So once it's done, you come to convert. It's the last step. And you can bake. You have different ways to bake. For example, here, I will select this guy. Let's just add a bit more. Okay. And I will bake and keep history. So bake plus history. Yeah. So you see now it's really a mesh, as you can see here. I can even edit. But I keep the history, so I can still modify. Okay. Now, of course, if you come and you make a bake, the basic bake, it will bake and delete the curve. If you come bake plus curve, of course, it will bake, clean the history, etc. You can see in the outliner. But that keeps you the original curve in case you want to reuse this. But you see, no link, no history. Okay, really simple. And last things, of course, there is perfect UV on those guys by default. Okay, see, UV, nice. So we can now add a material. So I provide a full material that works well with a cable. So let's add the first one. Of course, we need to switch to texture. See, so the first is a kind of plastic. This one is more a kind of, you see, with some bump and displace. You can come here, you select the mesh and you hit this button. Your Maya will freeze some second, and now you have in the viewport displays preview. Okay. So let's switch to another one. So if it's not on the right scale like that, just edit a bit the shader, because of course, as you can understand, all will depend on the scale of your scene. And the scale of your cable, etc. So you need to just come here and edit the repeat UV to find, you see, the right value. So we have also this guy. Add a bit more density, nice. And you see, you even have preview displays that add a bit of variation on the geometry. That is really nice. So yeah, just some material preset with a displays and everything. You have the displays control here for the intensity. Of course, if I come to hide. Okay, so it just based on the shade it Okay, is a special from Shadit I made here, just in case. Okay, so it's all for the basics, okay, of cable. Okay, now let's talk about the new dynamic tab that will allow you to make some simple dynamics on your cable. Okay, so first, it's not about in-depth VFX dynamics. Okay, it's just a tool to help you to quickly find a form and make a shape. Okay, on your cable after you bake and you have your little cable with a nice collide with your environment. Okay, it's not dedicated to replace in-depth FX. Okay, it's just some quick shortcut to in one to click easily make some dynamite collision and you have in place in right place your cable. Okay, so will you start with a clean scene, create really quickly an environment, really simple like that. Perfect, we don't need that, we are good, just a little bit. Okay, so one more time, dynamics also depend on the scale of your scene. Okay, here you see if I create a cube at 1 by 1, so my scene is about 50 centimeter. Okay, this about, it's less than 1 meter of scale. Anyway, the most important things about dynamic is that you should create dynamic before to create the cable. Okay, of your rules that will not work. It's just the only rules you should respect. Okay, so okay, let's try. I will create a CV curve, boom, center pivot, and make this guy here. Let's try also with a Bezier one. Perfect, like that. And why not create quickly a ring one? I will just make some funny thing like that. Okay. Okay. So two different types of curve. Okay. So I don't create my cable. I need first to make it dynamic. Okay. So really simple. Select and you click make dynamic. You can see some problem. Okay. That appear. Why? Because in fact that will rebuild the curve. Okay, and in some case you will have a nice rebuild like this one. Okay, but other case that we need more sample, so just come here and up the value, make dynamic, and you see now it's clean. Okay, but I allow you to set that because if you have only a little, you know, just a little 2-point curve, you don't need to have a so height rebuild. Okay, so here you can come and set to 10. Okay, so yes, first if you want we can test that here. I will just hit this and we can add. In fact, when you click here, you create a system. Okay, you can see here our system, nucleus, and environment for dynamic. But you can always add while you're working new one, make dynamic, and this guy join the other one. Okay, now you need the timeline, you need everything. I will say okay, okay, boom, and play, and you have your dynamics by default. By default is that, but that works. Need a bit of fix. One more time, the dynamic depends on the scale of the scene. Now I have that, what can I do? I will wait before to create cable just to show you and you better understand. We can, for example, create collider, select an image and make collide. You need when you know when you make dynamite, it's advised to first click on this button to well come back to the first frame, then after play to well initialize, sorry, the node. And you see now that collide. Bon, the other one have a little problem, so because they are too big, I will create, for example, it's not a problem, a ground. Like that, and I will hide this guide, make collide. It's here and now, boom, perfect. Great. Now, what's happened? If, for example, we will focus on this guy, I create cable. You see, it depends one more time on the scene of my. I'm a bit too big on my scale scene, but it's not a problem. I will come here. Okay, add a bit of density section. And now, if I hit up, you see the problem is that it's not collide correctly. Why? Because in fact, you need to set an offset here. So I will hide this guy and just come here. You activate the offset preview, and this is the real offset collider. Okay, you see, it's where the curve will collide with surface. So you need just to adjust here. So little problem come from Maya that when you adjust, you don't see feedback. You need just to up to click anywhere. Just click to this button to update and refresh. Okay. So I will just yeah, this guy is a bit too big. Okay. And here, for example, let's say I will boom to 4. Okay, maybe 5. It's about. Okay, nice. I uncheck that. And now, for example, boom, you see that collide correctly from the right offset scale. Okay, simple than that. Yeah, just be careful that affect all the curves. Okay, so not one by one, just all the curves are affected by those settings. Okay, so if you need different settings for different curves, you just works by group. Then you have some parameter like friction, 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 friction. If I just do that, okay, yeah, that list. If I up this guy, that will be, you see, a bit more sticky. The tray, the stretch, also just test. You see, with this value is less or more stretch. So by default, you see the pro. It's a bit. This value, sorry. It's a bit too elastic. So I add a bit more stretch. And now that keep better the form. You have a start curve. Okay. You see the default start curve. By default, no problem. But if you put this guy a bit, you will see the dynamic will not completely affect and it will tend to come back to the initial pose. Okay, that can be helpful. And finally, motion drag will add some, how to say, that will slow. You see, that will slow the gravity, in fact. Boom, and with motion drag, slow down. So like that, you can better right analyze what's happened, stop at this frame, bake, etc. And just finally, you have some point lock setting. You see that by default, both the base and the tip of your curves are locked. If, for example, I click on no attach, boom, everything falls. Just the base is attached, just the tip. Motion drag is a bit too strong, okay. And both is the initial one with both, okay. So you see just really simple setting, but just what you need to easily create your cable without too much in depth in the dynamics, okay. And finally, same things, when you're happy with your simulation, let's say this guy. Okay, I will select this and create some curve quickly here for those. Okay, so here I'm happy with that. Same thing, you back to baking tab and you can bake with history. So this way you will still have dynamic, etc., but you also have now a mesh on one. You can add, I don't know, your material or simply this one. Nice. Okay. So you can keep the history, of course, and that works, and you continue and you can animate, do what you want, and all the history is keep. You can come here and bake directly. So now, of course, this guy is dead. No curves, nothing, and same thing, you can bake with the curves, etc. Okay. The best things is of course to bake everything completely. Oh, not this one, is already baked. Okay. Okay. Then you can make delete history and you see here we have a lot of node. You just hit clean dynamic and that will clean everything. And now you have your geometry with nice collision, etc., UV and all. So here it's a bit long because I take time to explain you, but of course you understand that when you know the tool in some click, you have your cable in place. And if you have some residue, just make an optimized and it's clean. Well, cable 2.0 is available now on my gun mod, and for those who support the first version, it's of course free to update. Just re-download the new file and you have access to the 2.0 update. Thanks for watching, guys, and thanks to subscribe to be notified from the next script.